So welcome to this video, which is about the transport layer, transmission and acknowledgements. The purpose of this video is for you to understand how data is sent and acknowledged during transmission using TCP. So we already looked a bit of the steps when we have a connection and a connection oriented protocol. So we had the connection setup, the data transmission and the connection teardown. The connection setup and connection teardown we already looked at. So in this video, I will be focusing on how to do the data transmission and the acknowledgements. So the principle is that whenever data is sent, it's also acknowledged. And in principle, we could acknowledge every packet. But in, for example, TCP, we can also use what is called delayed acknowledgements, which can be used to reduce the overhead. What it means is that if we're sending a lot of packets, more or less at the same time, or with very short intervals between them, then instead of acknowledging each and every one of them, it might be sufficient to acknowledge, for example, every second one of them. So this is often done in TCP. What we know is that if a packet does not arrive, then an acknowledgement is not sent, and therefore it will be retransmitted. There is also another aspect of this, which is the flow control. So that's also an important part of the data transmission, and in TCP it's also built into the protocol, as you will see in a few minutes. So for the TCP acknowledgements, what we do is basically that we acknowledge on byte level. So if we look at the figure here, we will see that we have a sender and we have a receiver. To begin with, when we send the first packet, in this case, we have put the sequence number to be 0 just for a reference point. Usually, you could say that the absolute sequence number would be different because it is kind of randomized from the sender side, but often we like to refer to it with the relative values because it's easier to handle. So in the case here, we start by setting the sequence number to 0 and we are sending 2 kilobytes of data from the sender to the receiver. So we send the 2 kilobytes of data, we have the sequence number being 0. This means that the receiver is now receiving the bytes from number 0 to number 2047. Then he acknowledges and sends an acknowledgement number which is 2048, meaning that we are now ready to receive byte number 2048. So again, when we do the next write, we are again sending 2 kilobytes of data. But this time the sequence number is 2048 because that's the number of the first byte we are sending. So before we were sending number bytes 0 to 2047, now we are sending byte number 2048. And then we are sending these 2k bytes, and as expected we receive an acknowledgement number of 4096. So this is basically how it works. Then we have here also listed the window size, but that is something that I will cover in a later lecture. What is important to notice is if a packet is lost, so assume that packets number 1, 2, and 3 are sent, but the packet number 2 is lost for some reason in the network, then we will, when we receive packet number 3, we will send what is called a duplicate ACK. So basically, we will acknowledge that we have received the data from packet number 1. Once we then receive packet number 2 correctly, so we can say that this duplicate acknowledgement contains the information to the sender that packet number 2 was not correctly received because he just received the acknowledgement of packet number 1. Then he can resend packet number 2, and the sender hopefully is capable of keeping packet number 3 until packet number 2 is correctly received, and then he knows he has packet number 1 and number 2 and number 3. He can tell this from the sequence numbers, and then he can acknowledge that he has received also packet number 3. So that was a little bit about how this acknowledgement works in TCP, how we transmit and how we acknowledge. So thank you for watching the video, and let me know if you have any comments or questions about it.